A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 22nd Feb. On the front page here, this news: BSP to contest 38 seats in UP as SP settles for 37, RLD to get 3. This is actually regarding the political, alliances which are being made. This is important news. We'll hear review, please, on Rafael Supreme Court. So this you should know is regarding the case, the Rafael deal case. There are review petitions on this which have come before the Supreme Court, and the Chief Justice of India has assured petitioners that Supreme Court would hear the pending review petitions now. So that was the December 14 judgment in the Rafael deal, in which the Supreme Court had given a clean chit to the deal, considering that the CAG report has been submitted and reviewed by the Public Accounts Committee. But the fact is that CAG report has recently been submitted. So this is there. Then also correction, government has also filed for a correction on that same issue. Then this is, now all CAPF personnel can avail flights. So this is in the context of Pulwama attack. We saw that the government announced that flights can be used for CAPF personnel, Central Armed Police Forces personnel deployed in Kashmir Valley. So now all ranks of CAPF deployed in Kashmir Valley will be entitled to commercial flight services, to either join duty or while proceeding on leave. Then below you have this news: Assam Rifles granted power to arrest anyone in the northeast. So you should know Assam Rifles, which is a paramilitary force, it is deployed along the border of India with Myanmar. So it has now been empowered by the center to arrest anyone and search a place without warrant in the border districts of Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur, Nagaland and Mizoram. So this has been announced now. It has been given powers under the CRPC, Code of Criminal Procedure. Earlier, Assam Rifles was making arrests only in areas where AFSPA was in effect. But now, as we see, Mizoram does not have AFSPA. So, it has been given powers under CRPC. Also, you can see here, it has been mentioned that the Ministry of Home Affairs has lifted AFSPA from some areas of Arunachal Pradesh to last year. So, now, similar powers have been given to Assam Rifles through CRPC. The sections of CRPC are mentioned here and what each of these sections provide for. Section 41, 47, 48, 49. Then here you have the new Supreme Court to hear plea for protection of Kashmiris from attacks. So post the Pulwama attack, we have seen these news reports coming of Kashmiris, especially students, facing public harassment and attacks all across the country where they are studying or working. Then on page 6 you have campaign on to prove Gumnami Baba is Netaji. So this is regarding Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Some family members of his have alleged that a sinister campaign is on by certain sections of the country to prove that Gumnami Baba was the nationalist leader Netaji, and it has urged the center to release all intelligence bureau files on the recluse. So they call it a criminal offense to term Gumnami Baba is Netaji, as Netaji in disguise, without any documentary or photographic evidence to support it. So Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose actually died in an air crash. So, but then none of his details have been found. So that is why remains have been found. So that is why it is considered that maybe he is alive and he did not die in that crash. So there was this Gumnami Baba who reportedly died in 1985. And there is this trunk load of personal belongings, including his teeth. But scientific DNA tests have established that it is not Netaji. So, on page 7, you have HAL production capability on par with peers. So this is what the HAL, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, has said. Its production quality and capability is on par with any other comparable aerospace original equipment manufacturer. So this is the chairman and managing director speaking. So it has faced several criticisms. So we have seen the Mirage crash which took place, that was also through HAL. So it was upgraded, Mirage fighter was upgraded by Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. Then also we have seen delay in various manufacturing, like for the Tejas aircraft, for the Rafael fighter planes also. It did not get the license to produce Rafael fighter jets. the Rafael deal, the original Rafael deal had HAL as one of the as the only member which would manufacture in India the Rafael fighter jets. So this is there. Then this is deadlier version of BrahMos to be tested in 3 years. So BrahMos, which is a supersonic cruise missile jointly manufactured by India and Russia, named after Brahmaputra and Moskva, the two rivers of the two countries. So this sleeker and more lethal version of this missile is under development. It will be a smaller missile which will fly at 3.5 times the speed of sound. So that is there. So it has been worked on. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Healing Touch. So this is regarding Kashmiri students across the country. It is said there is a need to reassure them of their personal safety rather than attacking them. And this is Half Measures. So this talks about Angel Text. It says that it is good the Angel Text has been moderated, but its arbitrary nature remains intact. So we have seen how the government has said that angel tax would be exempted for startup firms, for registered and eligible startup firms, which the government would decide. Then the lead article, The Great Indian Political Shift. So this is regarding various Ambedkarite Dravidian parties, parties representing the lower castes are visibly moving to a politics without othering. So they are not talking about the others, but they are talking about their own selves and how they are moving ahead. Then below you have picking sides in West Asia. So it says India could find it difficult to maintain balancing approach between different West Asian powers. The West Asian powers spoken of here are Saudi Arabia, UAE, and even Israel. So each of them are, you know, against each other, and India has relations with all. So that is the balancing act. Then on Fridays you have this yes no it's complicated approach on the op-ed page. So today it is, the question is, after the terrorist strike in Pulwama, is war even an option? So there are three viewpoints given here: yes, no, it's complicated. Then here you have UN Security Council condemns Pulwama attack, so terming terrorism in all its form as one of the most serious threats to international peace. The UN Security Council condemned the Pulwama attack and offered condolences. Then below you have, will stop India's share of water going to Pakistan, says Gadkari. So this is Water Resources Minister Nitin Gadkari, who has said that India will stop sharing water with Pakistan. So we have Indus Water Treaty of 1916 place under which we share waters as such. So it has been spoken of here that India would stop sharing water because it's an upper riparian state here. This decision has been announced when the implementation of Shahpur Kandli Dam project has also been initiated in Punjab, which is on Ravi River. So this is Ravi River, you should know, is part of the Indus River system. So here it is said that what India is doing is not actually stopping water flow to downstream Pakistan, but it is going to, with the help of these projects, it's going to use its share of the water. So once implemented, India will be able to use its share of water, which presently goes downstream to Pakistan. So of course, river would flow downstream; it will not stop flowing. But then, when dams are built within the limit that India can use its share of water, it is beneficial for the country. On page 11, you have lakhs of forest dwellers face eviction. So people across 21 states may be affected by the Supreme Court order that rejected their claim. So this is regarding the Supreme Court order on the Forest Rights Act. So this may lead to eviction of scheduled tribes and other traditional forest dwellers in 21 states. So this is a three-judge bench on February 13, 2019 has ordered chief secretaries of many of these states to evict those whose claim as forest dwellers have been finally rejected under the law. So this is a direction given on eviction. And it says the eviction should be carried out on or before July 24, 2019. Then this is a significant and successful visit. So this is Saudi Prince Mohammed bin Salman, whose visit to India has concluded now. So you can see the details of this this visit as such. He has also committed to invest up to $100 billion in India. Then this is Election Commission allot symbols to 27 unrecognized parties. So these are the symbols like chappals, tea filter, chapati roller, gas stove, phone charger, which are among these newly allotted symbols to various parties. Then on international page, you have Dhaka fire shows lapses in development. So there were illegal shops and overcrowding in Chowk Bazaar, and here fire erupted, which resulted in a huge number of people dying. At least 70 people have died here. On business page, you have we'll try to pass on rate cuts. So banks are saying that after the Monetary Policy Committee did a rate cut, they'll pass on this benefit to the consumers. Then BharatNet can monetize fiber assets. So this is regarding the BharatNet, which provides broadband services to rural areas. So BSNL, MTNL are loss making. So they have been asked to submit revival plans too, and how monetization can take place. So it is BharatNet program is being implemented through the public sector undertakings BSNL and MTNL. So this is Digital Communication Commission, which is the highest decision-making body for telecom sector. So it has given in-principle approval to monetize 2.5 lakh kilometer of fibers laid under BharatNet program by leasing them or selling the assets to private players, so that BSNL and MTNL can be bailed out. Then on the last page, you have World Health Organization prescribes aerobics 150 to stay fit. So it says inactivity in many countries is rising, posing higher risk of non-communicable diseases. And below you have Jaipur physicist solves puzzles on interaction of nature. So this is a Jaipur physicist who has worked on the standard model of particle physics. You should know about the standard model. It will be discussed or covered in detail in the PDF for today too. So he has explained new aspects of dark matter, dark energy, and disappearance of antimatter in the universe. So he has been recognized by Bell Corporation, which is an international body of around 400 physicists and engineers. So the recognition has been provided to this Indian physicist from Jaipur, Dinesh Kumar. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com, and here in the current affairs section you can download the monthly compilations, daily compilations, and also you can enroll for our course, current affairs course, where detailed video lecture of current affairs will be uploaded. A sample is uploaded here, so you can get access to it. So that is it. Thank you.